Good morning, listeners. You tuned in to the Healing Hour with Pastor Lalite. I'd like to say good morning to 007. Evangelist Branch and Elder Roberts, good morning to you. Good morning, Brooklyn. You tune in to the Healing Hour with Pastor Lalite. Don't you go anywhere. Don't you touch that dial. Good morning to Elder Roberts, Pastor Green, Evangelist Antoine. Thank you for tuning in and listening. This is the Hour of Healing, coming your way every Saturday morning from 8 to 9. Devin McSween, how you doing? Mrs. S. Bishop Anderson, who was just here. What a wonderful program.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. A pleasant good morning to all our choice radio listeners. We greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Today, it is a wonderful day. Hallelujah. It's the first day of September. And we just give God the praise as we move from one month to the other. And it is only by the grace of God that God just take us through the trials of life, through the storm and the weather, and amen, and the mountain, God take us through. Beloved, it is my pleasure to be with you again. Into the studio, coming your way, God have a miracle waiting for you. Remember, this is your healing hour. 1 hour. A packed program with anointed song and the ministry of the word. And this morning we thank God for Bishop Anderson, a wonderful man of God. And we thank God for all the choice radio ministers. Hallelujah, and the management team. Truly, we want to say you're doing a great job. And just continue to do the job that God called you to do. You will face testing, you will face trial. But we know that he that began a good work in us, he will accomplish it, according to Philippians 6. Amen. 1 and 6. Hallelujah. This time we want you to join with us in prayer. Hallelujah. And let us pray together. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we lift up your name today because we believe that God, you have given us that name. which is above every name. You have given us the authority to call that name, and in that name there is deliverance. In that name there is healing. In that name there is blessing. Hallelujah. In that name the devil tremble. But Father, we thank you to be here, sparing our life again. Hallelujah, for another day. And we can say truly, this is the day that you have made, that we can rejoice and be glad in thee. Dear Father, this morning we thank you for all the blessing that you have laid down before the foundation of the earth for us. Father, we pray, O God, today that as you bless this station and as you continue, O God, to give the management team the wisdom, my God, how to continue, Lord, to run this station effectively, efficiently. Father, we pray that you will provide all the financial need. We pray that the unity of the Holy Spirit will work through them. And Father, we pray that this station will increase, Lord, and it will reach, Lord, the many millions around the world. Father, we pray through this station that many will receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and many will be touched by the power of God. Many will be blessed because of this station. And Father, we thank you, O God, that you will cover all the ministers. And Lord, we pray that you will send forth the right minister who, Lord, fear your name, and who are willing to continue to declare the unsearchable riches of your glory. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will bless them and bless their family. O God, touch them and meet their need. We pray, God, today for, Lord, the radio listeners, those that listening by air, and Lord, those on the website. Father, we lift them up before your throne, and we ask you to bless them. And Lord, we pray whatever situation arise, whatever, Lord, conflict in the life this morning, I pray that the Spirit of God will bring healing to them and deliver them. Deliver the family, O God, the husband and the wives. Lord, touch them this morning in a special way in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we pray today, Lord, for this country, America. Lord, you have blessed this nation. You have set the wealth into this nation. And Lord, this nation have been a blessing to the nations of the earth. We pray today for the president. Lord, we ask you to give him the strength, he and his family, that they will continue, O God, in the office in which they were elected, Lord, not only by the people, but by you. Give them power to function each day in the life to make the right decision. We lift up to God our senators. Lord, we lift up governors, and we lift up, O God, the mayors, the councillors, and all the representative of government. So Lord, we lift them up before your throne. It is you that declare in your word that we should pray for them, those in authority. And we pray, O God, today that you will continue, O God, to work a work into them. Lord, it is not by might, it is not by power, but by your Spirit, Lord, that will control and lead our leaders to make right decision. Father, we pray that you will lead the security forces, and oh God, you will guide them and protect them. Lord, our service men and women, as they go out in the night season and they go through the dangers, leaving the family, oh God, we pray that your hand will be upon them and guide them, and they will return back to the family safety, in safety, Lord. Father, we pray today that the hand will reach down, oh God, and bring to light those
who have corrupt themselves with evil, who sell their soul to the devil, Lord, to rape our women and to kidnap and to murder. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will give leading, that, Lord, they will be apprehended and be judged. Lord, in the time of judgment, that they will come to the knowledge of the truth and turn their life to Jesus Christ. But Father, we pray for the safety of a nation against, Lord, every, Lord, attacks of the enemy. And Lord, we pray that you will bring to light, oh God, the terrorists and the nest where they gather together and plan. God, you will break the shackle, and that, God, you will give us security forces leading us as to apprehend and break that ring, that the life of our city and our country and our people will be safe. Father, we thank you, oh God, Lord, that the enemy will destroy, but we thank God that you are, oh God, is the battle fighter. And in the name that is above every name today, we pray that you will touch, Lord, Lord, those that driving on the street today, and as they listen from the car, as the listener in the office, as they listen in the business, as they listen, I pray the blessing of God, hallelujah, be upon them. May you touch those that seek and heal them today and bring deliverance. To those that don't, lift them up by your spirit. And Father, today we thank you, Lord, in the name that is above every name. God, we pray that your blessing will be upon my wife and upon our children and upon the saints, our church members. We bless them in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Could somebody just worship God today? Just open your mouth and give him thanks. Give him praise today. Hallelujah. Thank you. I want to say good morning to my wife Alice and to all our children. Hallelujah. Amen. In Trinidad and in England. Hallelujah. In Grenada, we just want to let you know that your pops love you. Hallelujah. And praying continually. We want to say hi to all outreach members. We want to say we love you. And we know that you're supporting us. Please continue. Amen. As your host pastor began, amen, to say he loves you. Amen.
Amen, Pastor. Amen. I'd like to say good morning to my wife, Marlene, my son, Denzel, my daughter, Demi, my mother-in-law, Maria. All Outreach Church, New Beginning members, good morning. Good morning to all the listeners in Grenada, Trinidad, St. Lucia, all the Caribbean islands. I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen, Pastor.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Naomi, I am a child of God, beautiful, good looking, created by Jesus, my Savior and my King. Intercept for little children to come on to him. What are you? Look how you are the watchful law. He's more than wonderful, so amazing. Take his precious blood and wash away my sin. Open windows and doors and pour out blessing.
Praise the Lord. I want to say hi to Pastor Blackman. Hallelujah. I know you did a tremendous work by Elder Robert this last, amen, for the tonight. We want to say hi to Elder Robert. Amen. I know that you had a tremendous week. Amen. And we were blessed last night as the Holy Ghost minister in the midst of us. Amen. Hi to Evangelist Branch. Amen. We want to encourage you. Don't give up. Keep on continue. Amen. The good work. Amen. Hi to Sister Maria. And amen, Brother Chris and Pamela. Amen. And all. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to encourage you. Keep on. Look up. Amen. Jesus love you.
This is the Hour of Healing coming your way every Saturday morning from 8 to 9 a.m. with Pastor Ignatius Lalite. Remember, you can call for a prayer. Number 347-663-8638. The number again, 347-663-8638. Call, there's a prayer for you. This is Choice Radio 92.9. The number again, 347-663-8638. You can also view us on the web, www.westindianpeople.com. www.westindianpeople.com. If you're seeking the Lord, and if you're looking for a loving, caring group of Christian family to fellowship with, well, join us at 1509 Nostrand Avenue between Snyder and Erasmus. That's Outreach Church New Beginning Ministries International, Inc. We have service every Sunday at 11 a.m. We have a Christian Education Ministry and worship service. If you're hungering for the word, you can join us every Wednesday at 7 p.m. for prayer and Bible study. The demon-possessed family, if you have family problems, you're looking for a job, if you're brokenhearted, if you have marriage problems, come and receive a miracle from God every Friday at 7 p.m. We have our deliverance service, that is, 7 p.m. every Friday. And the address again, 1509 Nostrand Avenue between Snyder and Erasmus. And don't forget to tune in every Saturday morning at 8 a.m. For the Healing Hour with Pastor Lalite.
Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah. It's 8:22. Amen. In the studio now. Hallelujah. Just a while, we want to share with you. And I have something this morning special to share with you. Amen. The Lord impressed me that I should do it. Hallelujah. Everywhere I go. Hallelujah. And I want you to stay tuned. Don't touch a dial. Amen. Hallelujah. Remember, amen, this is your hour of healing. Hallelujah. God have a miracle for you. Hey.
recession, depression, and unemployment. This song's for you.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day. But where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower.
When I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over,
I smile, even though I hurt, see I smile.
You do.
I smile.
Come on.
Smile. It's so hard to look up when you get down. Show would hate to see you give up now.
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it still don't mean today don't have purpose. Come on.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
It ain't easy, but
today's a new day. But tell me, where are my blue skies?
Where is that love, y'all?
Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
The truth is,
I almost gave up, but a power that
praise the Lord. We want to say hi to Bishop Walker. Hallelujah. Amen, and we just bring greeting in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. This morning, amen, I want to share with you today, hallelujah, a testimony. Amen. And after we'll open the lines and we will take some call. Hallelujah. And remember, this is the hour of healing. Hallelujah. Don't forget, we have deliverance service every Friday, 7 p.m. Hallelujah. We have a structured Bible study on Wednesday, 7 p.m. Hallelujah. Hi, Sister Leslie, and we know today is your baby shower. Amen, and I hope that everything goes well. And Brother Kate, amen. I want to say hi to Byron and Tishina, who recently baptized and get married Sunday. And truly, we had a wonderful time in church. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Beloved, today, hallelujah, it is a pleasure to come your way through Choice Radio. And this morning, I want to share my testimony. Hallelujah. And I want some fathers to listen. I want some son to listen. And I want some parents to listen. Hallelujah. My name is Ignatius Lalite, and I was born on the island of Grenada, better known as the Isles of Spice. I grew up in a family of 15. We have 8 boys and 7 girls. And I was just in the middle. Hallelujah. My father, amen, had a good ability for business. And because of his alcoholic problem, hallelujah, we had to struggle in life. My mother sell alcohol and tobacco to help bring in, amen, some money to help the family, because we come from a large family. Hallelujah. And as we grow, My father used to give us a little drink, hallelujah, of the alcohol. And he said that, take this, it is for the worm in your belly. Hallelujah. And we take it and we continue, amen, continue to drink before our present. After a period of years, my father, the alcohol began to affect him. And then my father began to be so abusive to my mother. And as a young man growing up, it affected me. It really affected me. Because everybody wants to have a happy home. And my father, when he drink and he'd get drunk, he will abuse my mother. And sometimes she have to run from him. And he will pull the cutlass and run after her. And my mother sometime, she run through the bushes. And she don't come back for the night. And there's time when my father run after my mother. And he didn't get her to beat her, to do her what he want. He will come home and take out the rage on us. And sometimes he gets so mad that he will take a bucket of water and just throw on us while we were sleeping. And, you know, we were young, children growing up, we can't do nothing much. Hallelujah. And it continued for years and years. And as my brothers and them grow older, becoming into young men, each man just live in the home because they can't stand my father's behavior. Now I was the one that, you know, loved by my mom, and I love her, hallelujah. And I decided that I'm not going to leave as my brothers and them. I'm going to stay with my mother, hallelujah. And hallelujah. Because of the abuse of my father, I grew up, amen, decided one day I will end my father's life, revenging him for my mother. I grew up in a place where the environment was also bad. They had gangs, and where you had to defend yourself at a very early age from this gang, because they will beat you, they will chop you, and they will take advantage of you when you don't have much people to stand for you. So we began, amen, to, you know, take the knife and put it in our clothes so that we could defend ourselves at, amen, against this gang. We continue that life, and you know, it was so bad. I used to leave and go down, amen, to the bushes, and I used to cry and ask when it gonna stop. But there was a desire in my heart to read the Bible. When I was 8 years old, I grew up in a Catholic religion, and I read the Bible, and the Bible was the best book for me to read, because through my frustration, I find a relief when I read it. I pray how I could have prayed, but the abuse continued. One day, hallelujah, when I reached at the age of 11 years, I was a hard drinker. Amen. The spirit of alcohol seemed to take a hold of me. And I continue. Because of the abuse because of my parents was unable to for me to continue in the school. I had to drop out and look for a job whereby I could able to help my mother with the other kids that is small, even growing up. Hallelujah. At the age of 18, I was addicted to alcohol and drugs. I used to hear a voice talking to me and telling me what to do. And I will follow that voice and do what that voice say. There's many times that I will just reason with myself because, amen, I felt sometime this was not good for me to do. Not realizing it was the devil. Hallelujah. At the age of 25, I began to find myself into the same gang that I am myself to fight, amen, to defend myself, and I began to join them. And we continue, amen, to do a lot of bad things, stealing, you know, and cussing and, you know, doing bad things and fighting. I always tell my mother, if anybody come close to me, I will have to finish them because I don't want nobody advantage me and get away. And I stand, amen, against all odds, against my family, my young brothers and sisters, hallelujah, as the elder one that remain. But my father continue in his alcoholic, in that drinking habit. Hallelujah. Beloved, I met my wife, I met this young lady, very intelligent, and we start going wrong. I'm the kind of person that no parents, all girls that like me, the parents never like me because of the condition that I was in. And I can, you know, understand because everybody wants good for the children. But somehow that she fell in love with me and we felt for each other. And, you know, but that didn't change my addiction. And there's time when I would tell her, this life is not for you. And to go and find somebody who is able, amen, that, you know, that life that is good for you. But somehow she stick it with me. And I began to start to behave so bad. We always end up in problem. Hallelujah. I told my mother that if anybody come close to me, I'll finish them. And I meant it in my heart. I believe that I reached a place that I believe I move out from the Bible and believe that when I die, I will go to hell. And I want to get the job in hell to light the fire because I believe that, amen, all those who come down there, I will, hallelujah, I will burn them, hallelujah, who have done harm to me. Beloved, this was my mentality. This was what I decided in my heart to do. But praise God. Hallelujah. Not knowing the hand of God was upon me. So my wife, amen, she born in Trinidad. And we met in Grenada. And she decided to go back and she encouraged me to come to Trinidad. I decided to go to Trinidad after a hard fight with her. Hallelujah. And we went to Trinidad. And in Trinidad is a place of party, a place of fete. But in spite of it, I end up had, amen, I've learned to be a skilled man, and I always wanted to have my own company. But being an addict is not an easy task. It is not an easy life. And so that we went to Trinidad, we continue. We got 5 beautiful children, three girls and two boys. And amen. But in my heart, I don't want to be like my father. In my heart, I was crying for help. And in Trinidad, after getting the breakthrough in having, you know, this great knowledge of skill, I had my own company and had people working with me. And I had a driver driving my car. And one day he did something very bad to me. And I decided enough is enough, that I will have to finish him. So I plan to destroy this man and his family. And the devil gave me a master plan. And I go, amen, and I decided to really go after this plan. So I take my drugs and I take my alcohol, and I get myself ready for the occasion to finish this man and his family. And the place was, he was leave way down in the back, and you know, the place was dark. It was a nice occasion to do whatever I set my heart to do. But when I was going to that home that night, just 500 yards away, I heard a voice saying to me, "It is time. It is time. It is time." I stood and I reasoned with myself. I didn't want to make a jail for him. So I decided that somebody see me, and I will change the plan. I decided to go back. I left, turn away from that sin, with intention to plan another time. When somebody do me any harm, I go and sleep with it. And unless I do revenge them, I don't feel happy. So I went home, and as I went home, I went to my bed, well intoxicated. And while I was lying on my bed, thinking about another plan, and the sleep was just going with me, I felt that I something take place, like I felt a vision was coming forth. I felt that, amen, something was happening. And I just had this vision. My eye was open, and I was going up a steep, narrow hill, looking for a white man for a job. I had two people with me. And as we climbed that hill, on the eastern side, there was a lady with a flat house sitting on top of the hill. And this lady was sitting in a porch. And as we reached up the hill, she pointed me and said, "Son, listen to me. Jesus is coming." And as she said that, I heard this noise. And I look up to the heaven. And when I look up to the heaven, I saw the Lord Jesus Christ. There was a glory round about him, brighter than the noonday sun. His eyes were like the flame of fire. His garment was white as snow. Reading my Bible, I knew that when Jesus comes, there will be no time to repent. So I fell at his feet and I began to weep, knowing that I should have repented. And it was one of the most painful times for me when I fell before the presence of Jesus Christ. And as I began to weep, life left my body at the feet of Jesus. And I woke after a couple of minutes at the sound of his voice. And the voice was like the sound of many thunders, and the earth began to shake. At that moment, I fell off the bed and I began to tremble. And I began to scream. And my wife heard me, and the children heard me in the other room, and they came. It was about 2 o'clock in the morning. And when, you know, asked me what happened, with tears in my eye, trembling, I began to tell them that I saw Jesus Christ. And I was so afraid and so scared. With tears in my eye, trembling, I asked them to kneel with me beside the bed. And they kneel with me, and we commit our life to Jesus Christ. It was the first time I ever kneel with my children to pray. It was the first time I asked them to come and let us pray together. And beloved, I used to drink for 4 days, no eating. And sometimes I vomit blood. And sometimes when I couldn't sleep at night because my heart was just revving. Hallelujah. But at that moment, my heart was made whole. At that moment, the desire for joy had disappeared. The desire to curse and to steal and to fight, and every bad thing will just disappear at the presence of Jesus Christ. I decided to take my family to church. And beloved, 2 weeks straight, tears in my eye, weeping before God for all the things that I had done in my life. And I find a small church around my village. And we went to this church and get baptized. There was a wonderful man of God. And we continue. The Lord himself will come back to me on many occasions and show me the things he will have me to do and the places he will have me to go. And I began to prepare for the ministry. And my pastor used to encourage me and tell me, "Brother, God have a great mission for you." Very few men ever had this revelation of Jesus Christ. Then I read about Paul on Damascus Road. Then I start to read about the great heroes of the Bible. And beloved, I began to prepare myself 8 years preparation. And I said, Jesus, give me enough wisdom. Let nobody fool me. And give me enough love that I will love people. In Choice Radio, listener, from that day onward, the presence of Jesus is within me. The presence of Jesus, I feel there is a line connect to my heart, to the heart of Jesus. And at the time of circumstances, it become more real to me. Hallelujah. It become more real to me. And after 8 years preparation, the Lord came back to me and tell me this time to take my Bible and get out on the street. And I began to minister to people. I began to minister to my whole community and let them know about this Jesus. Beloved, if I see him in his saving grace, and it was so terrible, I don't want to see him when he comes in as a great judge. And this is the power that kept me going on 31 years now, serving the Lord. Beloved, this is not about, I didn't come and I was sent by a religious group. Every place that I go, even to this country, the Lord ordered my footstep to come. And I found that great love manifest in my heart. And the Lord sent me back to this very family and minister to them. And this family gave their life to Jesus. The Lord sent me back to my family. And my family began to receive Jesus. The Lord sent me back to my friends and them who used to take the drugs and the alcohol. And I have saw many of them come to know Jesus Christ. And God sent me as a messenger to let the world know that this Jesus Christ, who came more than 2,000 years ago, he is not just a human frail body that went up on Golgotha Hill. It is God himself manifest in the flesh. This Jesus I'm talking about, he is the Word. He was in the beginning with the Father. All things were made by him, and without him there were nothing made. This Jesus who came to shed his blood for the sin of Adam and for the world, he's coming back again. And surely, beloved, hallelujah, one of the greatest insults that people can do, and they will be judged not because of the sin that you committed, amen, just the adultery and fornication and all the sin, but you will be judged by rejecting the blood that offered for the sin of mankind. Beloved, I have news for you that Jesus is coming again. And Jesus wants you to prepare yourself so that you can receive, he can receive you. And the gospel is preaching to the nation. And what I'm talking to you about is not about a little religious group. You know, we have people just don't know God, just don't know him. And they continue to establish church. They continue, amen, to play around. But I have news for you. That God, who is all seeing and knowing, he knows everybody. And he knows every works.
And every work will come into judgment. And God is going to judge the nations of the earth. Hallelujah. The Bible says at his presence, the mountain will be removed out of his place. And the great men, and amen, and the rich men of the earth, hallelujah, they will say to the rock, fall on us, for the great day of the Lord is come. But the Bible said the mountain will be removed out of its place. Hallelujah, amen. And the place will remain naked, that there will be no hiding place for no man. And I want you in the amen to hear me today, the nations of the earth. I want you to hear me today. It is time to stop play with your life. Amen. Minister, it's time to stop prayer along with the gospel. Because the gospel is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believe it. Ladies and gentlemen, today I stop by to tell you that Jesus Christ is alive. Sit at the right hand of the Father, and the signs of time is everywhere, and he's coming again. Hallelujah. And he's coming again, and he will judge every man according to the work. Hallelujah. I don't care who am. Amen. Hallelujah. What position that you are in. Amen. Mr. Hallelujah. Adulterer. Fornicator. I want to let you know, Mr. Drunkard. And you, amen, homosexual and lesbian. I want you to know that you can take your pleasure in what you want and forget about your maker. But the hour is coming when he will judge you. Amen. And if he judged Sodom and Gomorrah, and he judged the world in Noah days, he said, remember, hallelujah, that amen, remember Noah days, remember Sodom and Gomorrah. And Mr. President, I have news for you. Amen, hallelujah, and amen, the mayors and the counselors, amen, as a servant of God, as a messenger of God, that no money is going to save you. No, amen, whatever position you have in life would not stop God from his judgment. For the Lord declared that you must repent. Hallelujah, amen. Unless you repent, you shall all likewise perish. And ladies and gentlemen, the signs of time is everywhere. Hallelujah. I'm not just sent by a church to preach. Amen. The Lord ordered me to come to preach the gospel into every nation as I declare the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Father, I want to let you know that you that drinking and advantage the mother, you that advantage that woman, you don't know what you're doing to a child. And many young men are in prison today because they've been affected because of the father abandoned, of the father, amen, that abused the mother. Young lady, I want to let you know, hallelujah, there is a judgment coming. And all those that are under the riches of my voice today, hallelujah. And you that say that you're an apostle and prophet and God doesn't call you, and pastors, God know who is amen, whom he call, and he gonna judge. It is time to wake up America. It's our time to wake up, amen, in the nations of the earth and leaders of the earth. That is Jesus Christ woke up, and Golgotha Hill is coming again. And he will judge the living and the dead. And this time I leave you with this message. Hallelujah. For prayer and counseling, you can call me off the air. Amen. 924-1448. 718-924-1448. Hallelujah. Our time is at hand. We're not able to take no call today. But I want you to know that we're going to be on the air next week, Saturday, from 8 to 9 with a power pack, amen, anointed service. Amen. We have a place of deliverance. Amen. 1509 Rogers, come on Friday. Come on Sunday. Come. Hallelujah. This is not about religion. This is about the power of God made manifested at this time to bring healing and deliverance to people. There's a lot of people in church still need deliverance. Hallelujah. And I invite you to come. Hallelujah. For I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the ending, the first and the last. He that have an ears, let him hear what the Spirit of God is saying today. Amen. Hallelujah. As we come, amen, to the end, I trust that, amen, this testimony will be, hallelujah, something great that you will consider. Hallelujah. Apostle Devon is about to come in the house. And as we close up today, let me just say a prayer. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray that you will loose the nations of the earth. You will loose those who hear this testimony today. And they will commit their soul unto God, the faithful creator. Father, we release your anointing over this air. And we pray that the Holy Ghost will convict them, that they will turn and repent and give their life to Christ to save from the damnation of hell. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't forget, praise on the water. Get a ticket. God bless you. Amen.
Building my temple here. A palace of praise, a throne of thanksgiving, made for the King of Kings. Sing up a joyful song. When praises abound, his glory surrounds us, filling his temple here. Sing, sing out, Lord is near. Sing out, the Lord is near.
Build him a temple.
Build him a temple here.
A palace of a throne of thanksgiving made for the King of Kings.
Sing up a joyful song. His love goes on and on. When praises abound, his glory surrounds us, filling his temple here.
The song of his saints and lives in their praises.
The Lord inhabits the song of his saints and lives in their praises.
Oh!
Together as one, with music and singing, rejoice in all that the Father has done. Let's lift up an offering.
Sing out, the Lord is here.
Build him a temple here.
Build him a temple here.
A palace of praise, a throne of thanksgiving, made for the King of Kings. His glory surrounds us.
Shout to the cold.